Hello friends, welcome back. Did you like the bread? Nice, right? If you want to make this bread, you don't need yeast. Generally, we make bread with yeast, but if you want to make sourdough bread, you need something special called starter. So today I'm going to show you how to make starter at home. It's very easy to make. You can make the starter at home, unlike kombucha, kefir, for which you can't make the starter at home. So if you are not familiar with sourdough bread, let me tell you, now there is a trend going on to make sourdough bread at home. But this is not something we have discovered recently. This was always there, maybe around 4,000 to 5,000 years ago. And this was started by Egyptian people. But now it is very popular in different countries like US, Europe, even in Asia also. So basically sourdough bread is naturally leavened by a special kind of yeast we catch in the dough, and then this yeast help us to make the bread very easily. So if you are wondering why we should bake sourdough bread at home and not the bread made by yeast, there are some benefits of sourdough bread. For example, it is very easily digestible, and unlike other bread, it doesn't increase the glucose level in blood. And also research says that sourdough bread can reduce the gluten. It may not be gluten free, but it can reduce the gluten, and it is more nutritious because this is made by fermenting the dough, and when we ferment the grains or flour, it breaks down the phytic acid, which is anti-nutrients and which prevent our body to absorb the minerals and other vitamins. So by fermenting the dough, the nutrients will be easily available for our body to absorb. And sourdough bread also works like a prebiotic, not probiotic, prebiotic. So it is actually gut healthy. Sourdough bread is a bit time consuming, but it's worth trying. It's not only healthy, it's tasty too. If you like this kind of bread, you should make sourdough at home. I like to use the bread as my canvas, where I can do the design, I can show my creativity. So if you are also interested, let's start. To make starter, we only need flour and water. But today I'm going to add little bit apple juice. That's why I'm just grating the apple, because the apple juice will have lots of yeast and it will kickstart the fermentation. If you don't want to use apple juice, it's still fine. If you are a beginner, it's good to have a kitchen scale so that you can measure the flour you are using. This is the wheat flour I'm going to use. It's an Indian brand called Ashirvad. So I'm going to use 50% wheat flour and 50% white flour. Make sure the flour you are using is unbleached. This is very important. Don't use the bleached flour. And also the water you are going to use should be filtered water or distilled water. You shouldn't be using tap water. Tap water might kill the yeast. So here I have taken 15 grams white flour and 15 grams wheat flour. And now I'm going to use some apple juice. You can just consider 1 spoon of fresh apple juice. Here you can see I have used only 6 grams or 6 ml apple juice. So that means it's actually half spoon. So you can use either half spoon to 1 spoon fresh apple juice. And now I'm going to use this mineral water. So I'm not going to use any filtered water. I'll be using the commercial water what we get in the shop. This is very easy to get because some people, they don't have the filter at home. If you have noticed, I have also used 29 ml water. That means 30 grams of flour and 30 ml water. So we can call it 50-50 or 1:1 ratio. So remember to buy the mineral water from shop and always feed your starter with this kind of water. Don't ever give the tap water. So after mixing the flour and water nicely, I have put the lid on top lightly. Don't make it airtight because we need the yeast from air. You can use a kitchen towel instead of the lid, and you can also put one rubber band to know if the level of the flour is increasing. It's been exactly 24 hours and I'm opening at the same time I have made yesterday, and you can see the level of the flour has increased and the dough is quite jiggly now.
So this is the sign that the fermentation started. If the fermentation start, you will see lots of bubbles like this, and also it will be fluffy. Singapore is a very hot country, that's why the fermentation started very fast. If you are staying in a country where the temperature is not that much, like below 22 or 20 degree, then you might not get the fermentation started so fast, you might not get the bubbles so fast. Now I'm going to take out half of the starter and put it in another jar, and I'm going to use only half of the starter now. This method is called discard method. That means where you will discard some of the starter and you will add new flour. Yesterday I have used 30 grams flour and 30 ml water. That means total weight was 60. So ideally I have taken out 30 grams. So now I'm going to add 15 grams white flour and 15 grams wheat flour. And then I will add 30 ml water. So that means 30 grams starter, 30 grams flour, 30 grams water, which we can call 1:1:1. When you are using your kitchen scale, always remember to make it zero before you add flour, and after that again make it zero before you add water, so that you will not have any mistake in the calculation of the ratio, because initially it is very important to follow this ratio. It is very important to mix the flour and water very well so that there will be no lumps. I will try to clean all the sides so that it will be easier to see when the starter rises. Again, I will put the lid and I will also adjust the rubber band and leave it for another 24 hours in the room temperature. Today is the third day and I'm very excited to show you something. If you look closely, you can see there is a mark that the starter actually went so high. This is the sign that we have managed to catch the yeast who can survive in acidic environment, and it is quite active now. It has rose 2 to 3 times, but I can tell you the starter is not stable yet. We have to keep on feeding for a few more days. And if you want, you can use different jar every time you are discarding the starter and using new flour and water, but I'm just using the same jar. If possible, use this kind of spatula. This is very helpful because the starter can be a little bit gluey and sticky, so if you're using a spoon, it can stick to the spoon a lot. So today I'm going to use 30 grams of starter from previous starter, and the remaining I have added to the discard jar, and I will add 30 grams of flour and 30 ml water. But today I'm not using the kitchen scale. I can roughly measure how much the flour I need to make it 1:1:1 ratio, and then again I will leave it for 24 hours. Today is the fifth day and I have forgot to feed on the fourth day. That means my starter was outside around 48 hours without any feed. And if you notice, there is a very thin white layer which we can call cum yeast, and the starter has not rose also quite high. I have taken out the layer from top and now I'm going to follow the same routine. I'm going to again feed 1:1:1, that means equal starter, equal flour and water. And this could be a lesson for you, like if you forget to feed, what can happen to your starter if you leave it in the room temperature, especially if you are staying in a country where the temperature is quite high like Singapore. So that's why always feed your starter on time. And if let's say it's very hot outside, you can keep 12 hours the starter in the refrigerator and keep 12 hours outside the refrigerator, so that you can avoid getting cum yeast. Because once you get cum yeast, it's very hard to get rid of cum yeast. It can come again and again. So today also I have taken half of the starter and then I have added equal amount of flour and equal amount of water, and then mix it well. So by any chance, if you get the cum, just continue to feed them and your starter will be active again. 12 hours passed and you can see the starter rose so high, around 2 to 3 times. I will just leave it as it is and I will feed again tomorrow at the same time. Today is the sixth day and the starter is active and bubbling. And if you see here, the starter went high, more than double. If you remember, on third day, the starter also went very high, but it fell down before we feed them the third time. But today it has not fell down, it's still holding at the same position. That means the yeast we have captured in the starter are accepting the acidic environment. There was an ant I have taken out. So you can see here lots of bubbles and those the gluten structure. And every time you feed, you will see after 24 hours, the starter is very liquid. That is quite normal. Today I have taken only 1/4 of the starter. And the reason behind this is I don't want to use too much flour. So I have taken very less amount of starter and I have used the equal amount of flour and equal amount of water. So which we call 1:1:1 ratio. And if you are thinking those discard, what to do with those, there are lots of recipes. You can make crackers, you can make focaccia, you can make lot of things with this this discard. I generally make pancakes in the morning for the breakfast. This is a good way to use your discard. I will put the link in the description. You can follow those recipe how to use your discard. 12 hours passed and you can see the starter rose so high around 3 times, which is a very good sign. That means the yeast is accepting the environment and it's getting stable and stronger. Today is the 10th day and I have continued to feed my starter at the same ratio 1:1:1, and today I'm going to do a test to see how strong and stable my starter is. You have noticed that I have always used 50% wheat flour and 50% white flour. The reason behind is that the yeast will get some nutrients from the wheat flour. But also to remind you, you can't use too much wheat flour initially when you are starting to make the starter, because wheat flour will be very slow. It has less gluten and yeast prefer the flour which has higher amount of gluten. So if you are a beginner, don't use wheat flour 100%. So today I'm going to take 20 grams starter and I'm going to use 40 grams flour. Here, because of the daylight, you can't see the measurement on the kitchen scale. So basically what I'm trying to do is I'm going to feed double. Until now I'm always feeding 1:1:1 ratio, but today I'm going to feed 1:2:2 ratio. That means 20 grams starter, 40 grams flour and 40 ml water. I'm going to test with this double feeding, that means the double amount of food, how long it takes the starter to become double or triple. Mix them very well so that there will be no lumps. The starter behaves like human. There will be fluctuation in the growth. Sometimes you will see the starter is rising very fast. Sometimes the fermentation will be slow. It also depends on the weather. If the weather is very hot, the fermentation will go very fast and the starter will rise very fast. That means it will rise to the peak very fast. Okay, so I have added the rubber band and I have also put the lid on top. And I will leave it in the room temperature to see how fast it reached to the peak. Peak means the highest level a starter can go. After that, it will start falling down. And when it's falling down, that means the starter is hungry. And if you want to feed your starter more than one time in 24 hours, that is the ideal time to feed your starter again. So this way, if you feed 2 to 3 times, you will get the starter very strong, very fast. Just to let you know, in the left side jar, I have used equal amount of starter, flour and water, 1:1:1. And the right side is 1:2:2. So now I want to see which one increase faster and how much it will increase. I have kept my mobile on time lapse. And if you have noticed, the time was 4:28 PM when I started. You can notice here, the starter has reached to the peak. And now it's falling down, and left side one has only increased around double, but the right side one increased 2 times higher. So basically we can conclude that when your starter is stable and strong, you can feed them double or more than double, and it will reach to the peak very fast within few hours, and the level will increase 2 to 3 times than what you have fed them. Right now it's 8+, so it took around 4 hours to reach the peak. And now I'm going to show you one test, which we call a floating test. It will tell you if your starter is ready for baking bread. So once you open the lid, immediately take half spoon of starter gently and then put it on the water. And you will see the starter is floating if your starter is ready. But I will say the most important test is to see if your starter can increase 2 to 3 times within few hours continuously. The floating test is just to support your conclusion that your starter is ready. Here I have this 250 grams dough and I'm going to add 25% of 250 grams, which is around 62 grams starter, and mix the starter well with the dough, and then I will follow the technique to make the bread, which I'm not going to show you here, otherwise the video will be very long. I will only show you the final product and I will make another video on how to make bread.
So this is how we make the starter. If you want to make your starter more stronger, you can feed few times a day and you can continue feed them. Some people continue to feed them until 1 month before they make their first bread. So you can do that. Your starter will be very strong. But if you are busy like me, I only make once a week. So once we make the bread, after that we can keep the starter in the fridge. And then when you are going to make your next bread, you can take out the starter from the fridge few hours ago. You feed one time. After that, again you feed. And the second time, you can make the bread. So if you are not making the bread every day, make sure to feed your starter every 5 days or 7 days so that your starter will be staying active. And also watch out for mold. Like if you see any red or grayish or green color layer on top, that means mold is building there. So if you get the mold, you should discard the starter and start again. So that's all for today. If you are interested, stay tuned to learn this kind of breads, how to make nice design, a nice coating. I'm going to upload more videos soon. I always update fermented food and drinks recipes. If you have special things in your mind, you can comment below. And if you have liked this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Stay healthy and happy. Bye.